gonna be honest with you, white guys, you guys are, don't nobody trust y'all now. Don't nobody trust you. And it used to be like the crazy looking white dude nobody trusts. A white nigga in khakis, I'm getting the fuck out. Do you hear me? If he looks like he manages the Arby's, I got to go. What is he doing here? No, I never adjust, which is why it's taken me 17 years to make it. People are like, oh, where you been? I've been here just trying to figure out my life. I go on stage and that's what I deal with. Like, whatever I'm going through, whatever is going on in the world, I deal with it. Because sometimes I'm nonsense. It's fine. But I want to say something, you know? And that doesn't mean that I always hit the mark. It just means that I want to say something and I want to make sure that I make a great impact. And my responsibility is, maybe sometimes to my detriment, is to always push this narrative that if we still don't have it easy as black people. And not that we want it easy, but we should just at least have some form of rest. I should be able to wake up and be like, oh, I'm gonna live my day as Yamaneika and not have an experience as I go through the world where it's like, oh, somebody doing some shit because I'm black, or this, I'm being treated this way because I'm black, or I'm a woman. Sometimes you can feel powerless. And comedy, for me, is the thing that makes me feel powerful.
When we do go out to see comedy, we seek it. We go out and we seek it. I need to laugh, you know, because something's going on. I got one bit about, we always talk about white male privilege in this country, but we never talk about white female privilege, which I think is a lot more privilege. When I hit that beginning part and I say that, you'll see some of the looks go like, what? What privilege? Then when I break it down, I get to one of my first bits in that joke. I wish I could be as comfortable around the police as drunk white women. And I start breaking it down about things I see them get away with versus what we can get away with. And this is a true story. I seen a white girl pissing between the cars. And this officer was being so patient with her. Ma'am, could you please? Ma'am, when you're done. Ma'am, could you please? And she turned up, looked at him and said, get out of my face, you fucking pig. And there was a part of me that's looking at that. It's like, word. You tell him. You fucking pig. But then there was a bigger part of me, knowing that I couldn't get away with that, that kind of wanted to see the officer tase her just a little bit. Because you need to know it's real out here. I couldn't get away with half of that shit. Meanwhile, he's calling you ma'am, miss, and all that. I've been called nigga for not turning around fast enough to talk to the cops. So, you know, sometimes they have the adverse reaction, but if it's a good joke, they'll take it as long as you get to a good punchline. They'll laugh at it at the end.
Eating and breathing have become unexpectedly dangerous in my life. I'm actually gonna stop calling my allergies that. That's a wimpy name for something that might kill you out of nowhere. So I'm now gonna call my allergies my police, exactly, because they might erase my existence and people will react the same way. Why'd you go outside that day? You guys know what I mean? Exact same disregard for human life. Okay, some of you with me. Some of you feel weird about race, and that's fine, because that's how I woke up. This morning and every single morning I've woken up just, what, black again, hope I make it. The police are out and it's already skin 30. I'm a contestant on Will This Get Me Killed? Anyway, guys, come with me or not.
When I moved from Atlanta to Indianapolis, there was no urban scene, so it kind of forced me into the mainstream circuit. So I would tell these stories and people would be blown away at how I was raised, you know, the type of parents I had, the environment that I came from. That's what they're learning when they come to my show. Like, hey, you want to close your door and act like people like me don't exist, but it does.
I'm 16 years old. I got 2 kids, 2 and 1 years old, and I'm living in the hood in Atlanta. And in this hood, I'm trying to survive. So I go out and start me a small business. Well, I was selling crack, but we're gonna call it a small business tonight. Okay, white people? I always had to keep a client in the car with me because I was 16 years old with a learner's permit, and I didn't want to risk the chance of losing my fucking permit.
I think it's an eye-opener when I'm standing on stage talking about my life so honestly, and I'm a girl. You really don't hear girls say they traffic cocaine, they've been shot. And I have this little saying where I say, hold my hand, white woman, I'm about to take you to the hood. You let it go, they're gonna get your ass. And I just walk them through all these crazy stories in my life. And I bring them back at the end in the comedy club and set them in their seats.